Sienna and the white, as you can see, we're starting to cut back on the areas that we spray the white in. And the next step will be transparent orange, but it's just used in the flesh tones and the beaks on the cranes, a little bit in the sky, so we'll kind of form that triangle between the two cranes, patch of sky over to the floating figure. And then the next step will be with raw umber, an opaque raw umber, and that one we spend a lot of time with, and that's when a lot of changes take place. So I'm going to leave the camera right where it is and do the orange, and then let you see what it looks like where it's been put, and then go right into the raw umber, and this time focus the close-in shot on the tree in the center. So get ready and go. Okay, we've finished now with the raw umber, the opaque raw umber, and hopefully you can see the changes, the subtle changes throughout the yellows have been a little tough to see, but if you're watching this live, it would be a little more dramatic with the raw umber finished. Now we're only one brown away, the burnt umber, away from starting to put the greens in into the forest. So our next step will be to run white over everything again, and then concentrate on adding a little more depth to the background areas and the spaces between the trees and the different levels. And then we'll move into burnt umber. So I'm going to get ready here.